Tesla threw a complete curveball on us and dropped the standard range Model Y, which, yes, Elon Musk said in a tweet last year would not be happening, and they had no plans on releasing it, and instead they were going to do a long-range single-motor version later, and it was going to have way longer range, over 300 miles, but instead, now the Model Y entry priced is $41,990. So, sadly, yeah, it is a bit more expensive than Tesla thought the standard range Model Y was going to be back when they unveiled it. They were listing it at around $39,000, but keep in mind, back when they unveiled it, Autopilot was not included. That was a $3,000 add-on. Now, Autopilot is included, plus this is still including the 19-inch Gemini wheels. When they first announced it, it was going to be the 18-inch Aero wheels. And another important factor is that they thought the standard range Model Y was going to go 230 miles on a charge. Now, they're coming forward with the number of 244 miles of range, which, FYI, is now the worst range Tesla on the site, but 244, still not bad. Elon said in the past they didn't really want to have range much below 250, and this is technically a little bit lower, but at the same time, they have now officially launched the 7-seater Model Y, which apparently also comes with some extra stuff. So they mention an easy entry into the third row, which I'm a little bit wondering how they're going to make that work. There's also third row USB-C charging, so the two, you know, 4'1" people you're able to fit in the third row of the Model Y are going to have charging access back there, which we didn't know about before, and you're still going to have those things in the trunk that allow you to electronically fold those seats flat. You can still fold the second and third row down to maximize storage space, but personally, having ridden in that Model Y several times, I can confirm to you guys, please do not get the 7-seater Model Y, especially if the people you plan on putting back there are over 5 feet tall. It's going to be really crunched unless they do some different manufacturing techniques with the whole back half, and I don't think they're going to. But obviously, very, very curious to see those first people who take delivery of the 7-seater Model Y. But yeah, would not recommend the extra $3,000. It's just going to be very crammed. And the more interesting part is the fact that the standard range Model Y comes with a premium interior. So this is actually a little bit different from the standard range Plus Model 3, which as of right now doesn't seem like there's any changes. But the standard range Plus Model 3 comes with a partial premium interior, which means that the sound system is tuned down a little bit to be not as impressive, and on the premium interior models, you get free premium connectivity, as in you can use cellular and the web browser wherever you are for a full year after taking delivery, and the Model Y appears to still offer that premium sound and that premium connectivity for a free year, so they're not pulling anything out at the last second like they are with the standard range Model 3. And also, a little bit of an interesting tidbit is the 0 to 60 time for the standard range Model Y is 5.3 seconds, definitely the slowest Model Y in existence, however, still pretty fast, and that's also the exact same 0 to 60 time as the standard range Model 3. So this puts around a $4,000 price difference between the standard range Plus Model 3 and the standard range Model Y, which personally, given all the perks you can get with the Model Y, and you have the same 0 to 60 time, and the range is only about 19 miles less, I think a lot of people are going to opt for the Model Y, especially now that knowing you can get that premium interior, and I think 244 miles is going to be good enough for most people. I don't think there's a lot of people out there thinking 263, that's good, that'll have me covered, but 244, nah, not gonna cut it for me. But my videos in the past before Elon Musk said that standard range wasn't happening was anticipating the Model Y to be around 41,000 entry level, and it seems I was only about $1,000 off, which is pretty close. Though I must say I'm very shocked, because Elon was hyping up that long range single motor Model Y for many months, and he was just saying how much better the range would be on that, and 250 is not good enough anymore. So this goes against a lot of the tweets he made, but this is legit. You can order one now. As always, feel free to pick up 1,000 miles of free supercharging if you use the referral code in the description. And holy cow, Tesla's gonna have to start pumping out Model Ys fast, because early 2021, the Model Y is now $8,000 cheaper than it was yesterday. And that puts it much more price competitive with vehicles like the VW ID4, and of course the Ford Mach-E, which is just coming out. It seems like Tesla had this in their back pocket, and they were just kind of waiting for competitors to get ready, and then Tesla was like, eh, you know what, deal with it. We got a standard range Y now, and the range is going to be great, and of course, you're still going to have access to supercharging, autopilot, full self-driving, the subscription once that gets announced. Just for some last-minute, like, tech spec things to throw at you, the weight is just under 4,000 pounds, so on the all-wheel drive long-range version, it's more like 4,400 pounds, so obviously because it's a single-motor vehicle, vehicle that's a lot lighter. And also, interestingly enough, they don't list the charging speed. So the charging speed on the Standard Range Plus Model 3 is actually a little bit lower than 250 kilowatts because the battery is smaller. So they charge at a little bit of a slower rate to preserve battery health, but miles per hour is still pretty close. But then with the Standard Range Y, nowhere on the site does it list what the max charging rate is. So my guess is similar to the entry-level Model 3, it's probably gonna tap out at around 170 kilowatt charge rate. And at this time, we don't know exactly what the battery capacity is of the Standard Range Y, but once we know, I'll be sure to keep you guys posted. But yeah, how about that? If you were waiting for a cheaper, lower range Model Y, you now have it. Let me know what you guys think of Tesla's curveball decision here, and should we ignore Elon's tweets more often? Feel free to let me know. Thank you all for watching. Hope you have an excellent rest of your day. Take care.